What's poisonous, polluting, and has contaminated most of history?
Toxic masculinity.
So how many of us have heard the term, boys don't cry, और लड़के रोती नहीं है?
Why shouldn't they cry? I mean, pain, both physical and emotional, is not a figment of her imagination.
Ideas about masculinity are drilled into our heads in various ways. Family members, the way we dress, our friends, boys' dormitories, locker rooms, the ad and film industry, and so on.
So this is made worse by peer pressure, where men are expected to fit into these norms which shouldn't have existed in the first place.
As cherry on the cake, physically violent and aggressive behavior patterns are demanded of boys and men.
Such as entitlement to public and private spaces.
This aggression is also demanded within relationships, especially with the women and girls in their lives. In India, the caste system and toxic masculinity go hand in hand. Brahmin and Kshatriya men embody ideal masculinity.
Their position on the top of the caste pyramid allowed this idea of toxic masculinity to infect the rest of the society and become a part of the dominant culture.
Remember those popular Amar Chitra Katha comics? They shamelessly catered to stereotypes about caste and masculinity. The gods, goddesses and Savarna factions were painted as fair-skinned and perpetually good.
The Asuras, that is Dalit and Adivasi persons, were demonized and painted as dark-skinned. This dark skin represented irrational evil.
Now, some of the gods were dark skinned too, but the creators of the comics were so hell-bent on differentiating and presenting them as good that they were painted blue.
Let that sink in.
Another source of toxic masculinity is bodybuilding culture.
If you want to stay healthy, good for you. But wanting to stay healthy and display that you are a violent alpha male do not go hand in hand. This shallow culture of machismo encourages men to ignore their emotional health.
And what is with this pressure to be an alpha male? What are we? Wolves? Just because it's a tradition or norm doesn't mean it should stay. It's time for us to evolve.
Remember, the stereotypes about masculinity don't let men talk about their own stories of physical and sexual abuse.
And the myriad of other ways in which patriarchy victimizes men.
A study in the Straits Times found that children being told to man up are 4 times more likely to become bullies.
According to the National Crime Records Bureau, nearly 70% of suicides in India comprise men.
The World Health Organization has acknowledged that the pressures of toxic masculinity and the shorter life expectancy of men go hand in hand.
Taking all of this into account, why are we still telling men to man up? Given how dominant toxic masculinity is there an alternative? When toxic masculinity exists, so can non-toxic masculinity. Why should our ideas of strength and bravery be limited to violence and aggression? Strength and bravery can also be vulnerability and empathy. Can we then envision masculinity as one where boys and men treat people the way they want to be treated themselves?